April 24th, 2015. There was just some days you just never forget. I was outside giving my dogs their last little walk and I had no balance and things started spinning. I immediately fell to the ground. I felt like I was drugged. The ambulance came, they start the IV and they were just, oh, this is vertigo. They'll give you medicine at the hospital. I'm thinking, you know what? This is very serious. I'm this healthy, productive, active person all of a sudden dropped to the ground and had no function. I'm at the hospital, 6 days goes by. They tried everything. They didn't know what happened, but they knew something besides just vertigo is going on. When somebody says to you that they don't know what's wrong with you, but you're permanently disabled, you're gonna be home in a wheelchair, I think it's time for a second opinion. I'm slowly typing it into the computer. I'm slowly reading what pops up. Then popped up the vestibular clinic at Johns Hopkins, and it described all the things that I was going through. And I wheeled myself down to the social worker's office and I banged on the door and I said, you need to make this referral.
In cases like Angela, a viral inflammation around the nerve connections between the ear and the brain can cause irritation and result in symptoms which is called vestibular neuritis.
You know, he said there was no medication and there was no surgery, that the only thing was retrain my brain through a certified vestibular physical therapist.
Our brain has a set point for how much it relies on information from each ear to maintain balance and control our eye movements. When there is a disruption in this process, the brain needs to learn how to incorporate the changes, adapt, and establish a new set point. And that comes with practice.
My full-time job became recovering and healing. The best thing I could think of was riding a bike. I only envisioned in my head the end result. I was going to be riding this bike, and it was going to help me with the depth of field, the perception, the movement, judging other cars, other people, the whole thing. I was riding 5-6 miles a day for 3 months. It was scary, but I don't know what's scarier, falling down from trying to ride a bike and learn how to get yourself back together, or living a life in a wheelchair. Like, is there a decision? Not for me, there wasn't. I feel like I am 90%+ back. I have some struggles, but it's nothing that keeps me from living the active, productive life that I am doing and I deserve. I'm not in a wheelchair.